The Frank-Hertz experiment apparatus allows you to demonstrate the quantization of argon energy levels and to measure the first excitation potential of argon. The tube is a tetrode tube, and the schematics have the following attributes. The electrons are accelerated between the grids. An opposing voltage between the second grid and plate prevents electrons with insufficient energy from reaching the collector. As the ramp voltage increases, elastic collisions occur until you reach the first excitation energy level. Then the electron loses energy and the process repeats itself. This results in a series of peaks and valleys in the current versus accelerating voltage. The four voltages that you will use for this experiment are the filament, first grid, plate, and second grid. You use the knob at the bottom to indicate which voltage you are adjusting at the time, and it is displayed on this screen to the right. The range display for electron current is the top knob, and that will be displayed on the left. When you're collecting data, you can either use the auto or manual switch. If you use the manual switch, it does not matter if you choose a fast or slow for this method. You do have to manually change the voltage one data point at a time. If you choose the auto method on top, you can connect these to an oscilloscope and display the data much faster. If you wish to use an oscilloscope, I would recommend a minimum of 20 megahertz. In this video, we're using a 50 megahertz oscilloscope. You can use either the XY mode or, as we have set up here, the two-channel mode. Before you start the experiment, you should zero out all the potentiometers, turn the apparatus on for 3 to 5 minutes to allow it to equilibrate. Then from the manual, we're going to jump right to the recommended voltage settings. You can change these or adjust these, but I really recommend going by what the manual is to give you the best results. So let me scroll through the different settings. On the oscilloscope, we have the accelerating voltage on the bottom and the current at the top. So as the ionization energy level is reached, it gets excitation, then it drops down. I have outlined two minima, and the difference in the voltages are noted off to the side. If you take the difference in voltage of two minima and divide by two, you will get approximately 11.6 volts, which is the excitation energy for the first level for argon. The precision and the quality of the Frank-Hertz apparatus in argon makes it easy for you to study this in your classroom. Students can demonstrate the quantization energy of argon as well as measure the excitation level of the first excitation level of argon gas. If you need to, you can use this by itself and make it a manual learning lesson for your students, or you can connect it up to an oscilloscope and make it a very quick, very visual way to reinforce those important principles.